We're broadcasting live from the Dirty South Dome in Atlanta, Georgia, where the living's easy and the sushi is called bait.
I thought you said her name was Susie. But you're right, she did look a little older. 15 at least.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Malice Hellboys take on the Atlanta Vultures. Win the brain toss and receive. They want the ball first. Hi, this is Grim Blitzrow, and welcome to the Mutant Football League. We'll be right back for kickoff, but first, let's listen in on the pregame speech. Hello, once again, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan. Hey, how'd your checkup go?
Well, good news, bad news. Doc says I passed my physical.
Oh, that's good.
But I flunked my mental.
Not too good.
Well, it's 50-50. Better odds than I get in Vegas.
Get a point. Football is a team sport, and that's why you should never think about mine unless it's that kind. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. The quarterback changes the play. And that player just transformed into a giant. Good luck blocking this guy. Ho-ho. And that'll give him four more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. First and 10. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. First down and one. You never know if it's a regular audible or if they're going to call a dirty trick. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not going to dance.
The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. First down, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. Picks up maybe four on that play. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And he picks up 10 on that run. Man, he nearly broke that one open, Bricks.
Yeah, and I nearly married Trin Bigassian. And I nearly did not crap my pants earlier. Nearly as overrated, Grin.
Third down and, well, good luck. Broid Rage, how do you like your brains? You know, comments after last week's game were blowing up on Shitter. Critics said he should shut up or blow up. Well, two birds with one stone there, I suppose. And the defense is on his heels. Close, but no cigar. And it's first and 10. The defense just called an audible, and the QB is praying it's not a dirty trick. That's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Second down and a lot.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the play. They could not connect on that play. Smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the after.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And so at the end of the first quarter, we've got a scoreless game.
Just like you love life.
He could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Second down and 10. And the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick. Man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
Celebration. I like this. They're going for two. And the defense stops him cold. That play just got blown to hell.
Yeah, it got blown to shit.
Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. They just called an audible on defense. Offense hopes it's not a dirty trick. He picks up a two. And that'll be second and 8 to go.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And it's your mother ever tell you don't run with a chainsaw. And heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. When it's your time to go, it's your time. Second down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down in a mile.
Hot one, hot two.
When defensive players go berserk, they've been known to rip the heads off of enemy players. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path.
Goal!
And the defense calls a timeout. Wonder what for?
Yeah, usually they just scratch their balls during the timeout. Geez, don't
most likely. I just douse it with lighter fluid. Little grass fire scares the little bastards.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. That's a bad kick, and it's going to cost them some yards. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. Pow! With the brain scrambler! And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And that's a run for no gain. And we're at the 2-minute warning. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Great play by the defense results in an interception. And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just getting the points, and let's move on.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down and long.
Way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And the offense formation to try to conserve time. And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. Second down and long. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Rip, can I kill him?
And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
Put a little too much on that ball. This will be a touchback. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, the Mutant Football League halftime show. And here's a tip, don't die. He's out of rounds, find a rifle, man. You just brought yourself some time, partner.
If the player who died was Chinese, do you think the zombies would use chopsticks on him?
We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Away from that tackle, and the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
Well, he made the pass, but then a slap in the face by the defense.
Oh, that's me in the hotel bar every night.
Hey, your opening line needs work.
Why?
Really? What's a pretty girl like you doing here all by yourself? Are you a hooker?
Well, it's a fair question.
Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here. And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit. First and 10. TV calls an audible. Is it a dirty trick? We'll find out in a second. That's a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. His way out of it. Man, guys like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. first and 10.
Welcome to the Groin Rage. How can I help you?
That was a good throw, assuming he was aiming for the ground. Second down and 10. He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. And he runs it for 4 yards. Third down and 8.
And got a shot like that.
It wasn't licorice, you idiot. It was the frayed cords of the leaf blower.
Well, it was a red cord and it looked like licorice. The point is, I forgot my point.
Up 7 yards on that play. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Second and 3. And the quarterback calls an audible here. Laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and 10. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, Hey, I got a dollar for the bathroom attendant. He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. Second down and more than, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. How you play defense. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown to change the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. And they call a ginormous dirty trick.
He getting so big that the last time he saw 90210 was on the bathroom scale.
He rifled that one in there, and they come up with 10 yards on the play. The drive was stalled, and here comes the field goal attempt. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. 10-yard pickup there. Normally a first down, but here, he's just making up ground.
Yeah, like the way the commish makes up news.
Sandwich. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners.
And it's first and 10. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10. Call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Oh, with the brain scrambler. The defense has to make something happen here with 1 timeout left. This is going to be a rocket shot to the moon. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. They're marketing.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot.
In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, the player on roid rage would win. Keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
And it's first and 10.
When the defense calls an audible, you'll know that...
Kind of reminds me of that painting of dead carving the turkey. Defensive had the chainsaw on the turkey and screaming for his life.
She used to tell me I was a mistake a lot, though.
The offense, he's at the 10.
It's a touchdown!
Shiver!
offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, Grim.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. The defense has only one line basher left, and they need to keep him alive to avoid forfeiting. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The Atlanta Vultures win this one. After a stomping like that, the opposition may be a permanent part of the field.
More like a graveyard, Grim. There are body parts everywhere. And speaking of body parts, did I ever tell you?
Let's listen to MVP. I'm sure he has something inspiring to say. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Eagle SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every other time.